Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a free, complete course for the CCNA. If you like these videos, please subscribe to follow along with the series. Also, please like and leave a comment, and share the video to help spread this free series of videos. Thanks for your help. Also, remember to sign up via the link in the description to get all of the lab files for this course, so you can try it out yourself in Packet Tracer. If you want more labs like these, I highly recommend picking up Boson's NetSim for the CCNA. Click the link in the video description to check it out. It's a network simulator like Packet Tracer, but it's even better, and it includes all of these guided labs to not only help you get hands-on practice configuring and troubleshooting, but also deepen your understanding of the exam topics. I used it myself when studying for my certifications, so I feel confident about recommending it to all of you. If you want to get your own copy of NetSim, please follow the link in the video description. In this lab, we will do some simple IPv6 address configurations. But there's something different in this lab than what I showed in the video. This network is already running IPv4. R1 and the PCs are already configured with IPv4 addresses. We're not going to remove the IPv4 configurations. We're simply going to add IPv6 configurations on top. This is called a dual stack solution. It's one way of transitioning your network from IPv4 to IPv6. You keep IPv4 running, add IPv6 on top, and then slowly transition to using IPv6 exclusively. So let's add IPv6 to this network. In step one, we are told to enable IPv6 routing on R1. IPv4 routing is enabled by default. If you configure interfaces and routes, the router will forward IPv4 packets without having to separately enable IPv4 routing. IPv6 routing, however, is not enabled by default. However, just to show you what happens if you don't enable IPv6 routing, I'm going to skip step one until the end. So let's go straight to configuring IPv6 addresses on R1. Let's open the CLI of R1. Enable, conft, let's configure them in order. Interface G00. IPv6 address 2001:DB8:0:1:1/64. The interfaces are already enabled because this is already a functioning IPv4 network, so we don't need to use no shutdown. Okay, next interface. Interface G01. IPv6 address 2001:DB8:0:2:1/64. One more. Interface G02, IPv6 address 2001:DB8:0:3:1/64. Okay, that's all for the interface configurations. In step three, let's check the configurations. Do show IPv6 interface brief. These are the addresses we configured on the interfaces, but also notice that link local IPv6 addresses were automatically configured too. You'll learn about these in the next video. Next up, let's configure IPv6 addresses on the PCs. I'll go on PC1. Click on Config. And then from this first screen here, set the IPv6 default gateway, which should be R1. 2001:DB8:0:1:1. Next, click on PC1's Fast Ethernet 0 interface and set PC1's IPv6 address. 2001:DB8:0:1:2 and the prefix length /64. Next up, PC2. Again, set the default gateway 2001:DB8:0:2:1. Then set PC2's own address. 2001:DB8:0:2:2/64. Finally, PC3. First, set R1 as the default gateway. 2001:DB8:0:3:1. Then PC3's address. 2001:DB8:0:3:2/64. Okay, now let's go to step five and try some pings. I'll do some pings from PC1. First, let's try to ping PC1's default gateway, R1's G00 interface. Ping 2001:db8:0:1:1. Okay, the ping works. Can PC1 ping another interface on R1? Let's check. Ping 2001:db8:0:2:1. Yes, it can. So PC1 can ping its default gateway and R1's interface in another subnet. Can it ping PC2? Let's try. Ping 2001:db8:0:2:2. No, it can't. Let's try similar pings from PC2. First, let's ping PC2's default gateway. Ping 2001:db8:0:2:1. Okay, that works. How about R1's G00 interface? Ping 2001:db8:0:1:1. Okay, that ping works as well. How about pinging to PC1? Ping 2001:db8:0:1:2. Again, the ping between PCs doesn't work. Why is that? It's because I skipped step 1. I didn't use the IPv6 unicast routing command on R1 yet. So let's go back to R1. Use exit to return to global config mode. And let's enable it. IPv6 unicast routing. Okay, now let's go back to PC1 and try to ping PC2 again. Ping 2001:db8:0:2:2. Okay, the ping works. So make sure you don't forget the IPv6 unicast routing command when configuring IPv6 on a router. Just to show that IPv4 is working as well, I'll do an IPv4 ping to PC2. Ping 192.168.2.2. Okay, the ping works. So both IPv4 and IPv6 are working. Okay, that's all for this lab. Now let's take a look at a lab in Boson NetSim for CCNA. Okay, here's today's Boson NetSim lab preview. Actually, this lab isn't from the regular Boson NetSim for CCNA. It's from Boson's courseware for CCNA, which they released recently. It's essentially Boson's course for the CCNA, and it includes an extra set of labs which you can do in NetSim. So I've added a link to Boson's courseware in the description, so follow that link if you want to check out Boson's courseware and try it out. So the lab we're going to do is called IPv6 configuration. Here is the lab topology. As you can see, IPv4 is already configured on these routers. These are the commands you need to know. IPv6 address we covered, IPv6 unicast routing, and there are some others we haven't looked at yet. These are the IP addresses on each device, the IPv4 addresses, and then the IPv6 addresses, which I assume we will configure soon. And these are the tasks. Task 1, configure IPv6 addresses. And task 2, configure IPv6 between router 1 and router 2. And then configure IPv6 between router 1 and router 3. Okay, so let's just do task 1, or at least part of task 1, for this lab preview. In this task, you will examine the current network configuration and configure the appropriate IPv6 addresses on the interfaces. You will only perform steps on the physical interfaces shown in the IP addresses table. Okay, got it. So A, examine the initial network configuration. Examine the running config of all routers. Do the IPv4 addresses assigned to each router interface match IP addresses shown in the IP addresses table? Okay, let's quickly check that out. Enable. I don't need CompT actually. Show running config. Serial 00. That looks correct. How about fast Ethernet? 00. That is correct also. Okay, next I will open up the CLI of router 2. Show run. Here's fast Ethernet 00, and the IP address is correct. Okay. Next up, router 3. Enable show run. So serial 00, that is correct. Serial 01 is correct also. Okay, and finally, let's check on router 4. So we are checking serial 00. That is correct. Okay, so all of the IP addresses are correct. What types of IP addresses are currently assigned to the routers? What types? IPv4, I guess. These are public IPv4 addresses. I will tell you later in the course about public versus private IPv4 addresses, but these are not private addresses. They are public. What is the theoretical maximum number of unique IP addresses of this type that can be assigned? Of this type, I guess they might mean IPv4. So that is roughly 4 billion, over 4 billion. Actually, let me check Boson's answers for this one. So I will scroll down. Under the lab tasks, there are lab solutions. Okay, so the answer to question 2 was actually the type is IPv4. It's not asking specifically which type of IPv4 address. It means, are they IPv4 or IPv6? Okay, so, and I was correct. The maximum number of unique IP addresses is over 4 billion. Okay, number 4. Why is there a need to change this method of IP addressing? As I covered in the lecture video, there just aren't enough IPv4 addresses for the modern world where everything is interconnected, everything is connected to the internet. We just need more addresses. Okay, verify IPv4 connectivity between router 3 and router 4 by issuing the ping. Okay, issuing pings between them. Okay, so let's check. I'm already on router 4, so I'll ping from here first. Ping 180. This is pinging from router 4 to router 3. And it works. So the ping from router 3 to router 4 should work as well, but I'll do that anyway. Okay, looks good. Okay, part B, configure IPv6 addresses. IPv6 addresses will eventually replace the IPv4 addresses currently in use today. What are the expected benefits of this new type of IP addressing? Okay, so the only benefit I've introduced so far is that there are many, many, many times more IPv6 addresses available than IPv4 addresses. And really, that's the main reason. That's the main benefit. What are some of the major differences? For example, an IPv6 address is 128 bits versus an IPv4 address. There are, of course, other differences, but we'll cover those later. What is the theoretical maximum number? Okay, it is a huge number that I cannot say. Let's scroll down to the answers and see that once more. Well, here it is. 3.4 times 10 to the power of 38, which is a just ridiculously huge number of IP addresses. Briefly describe some of the techniques that will allow IPv4 addressing to coexist with IPv6 addressing. Okay, well, just in this previous lab, I introduced the idea of dual stack. So running both IPv4 and IPv6 at the same time. Okay, next, enable IPv6 packet forwarding on router 3 and router 4. Okay, that's easy. Here on router 3, conf t, IPv6, unicast routing. And on router 4, conf t, IPv6, unicast routing. Okay, finally, I think I'll end this lab here for now. Configure static IPv6 addresses for router 3's serial 01 interface and router 4's serial 00 interface. Refer to the IP addresses table. Okay, so router 3's serial 01, router 4's serial 00. first on router 3, interface S00. And the command is IPv6 address. And that'll be 2001:1:3:1:1/64. Okay, and that should be it for router 3. Next, router 4, interface S00. Actually, wait. Okay. I configured the incorrect interface on router 3. So I will know that command to cancel it out. And let's go to serial 01. Use the up arrow and enter the same IPv6 address again. Okay, that's correct. Okay, now router 4. IPv6 address 2001:1:3:1:2/64. Okay, so that should be it. Let's try a ping from router 4 to router 3. So I'll ping IPv6 and now router 3's address 2001:1:3:1:1. And the ping works. Okay, looks good. So that is today's Boson NetSim lab preview. Again, this is a special lab from Boson's courseware for CCNA. So if you want to check out Boson's CCNA courseware, follow the link in the video description, and you can also download a free sample from Boson. Before finishing today's video, I want to thank my JCNP level channel members. To join, please click the Join button under the video. Thank you to Magrathia, Unjabulo, Benjamin, Deepak, Tsepiso, Justin, Loki, The Gun Guy, Neil, Prakash, Nasir, Erlason, Apogee, Wasim, Marco, Florian, Daming, Kony, Joshua, Gilmar, Samil, Ed, Value, John, Funny Dart, Scott, Hassan, Gerard, Merrick, Velvijekum, C Mode, Johan, Mark, Yusuf, CD, Boson Software, Charlzetta, Devin, Lito, Jonathan, and Vance. Sorry if I pronounced your name incorrectly, but thank you so much for your support. One of you is still displaying as channel failed to load. If this is you, please let me know and I'll see if YouTube can fix it. This is the list of JCNP level members at the time of recording, by the way. October 10th, 2020. If you signed up recently and your name isn't on here, don't worry. You'll be in future videos. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, like the video, leave a comment, and share the video with anyone else studying for the CCNA. If you want to leave a tip, check the links in the description. I'm also a Brave verified publisher and accept BAT or Basic Attention Token tips via the Brave browser. That's all for now.